Let us discuss about work done in changing orientation of a current carrying loop in magnetic field. Here you can see in this situation there is a uniform magnetic field in which a current carrying rectangular loop is placed, and here you can see the direction of its area vector, magnetic moment vector is making an angle theta with the direction of magnetic field. So here if we calculate the initial, that is the present state interaction energy of loop with B vector, then we can write its initial energy is minus MB cos theta 1, because it is making an angle theta 1 with the direction of magnetic field. Now if the loop is externally twisted, here you can see, to a position where the magnetic induction vector is making an angle theta 2 with the direction, new direction of area vector or magnetic moment vector. So here we can say in final situation, final interaction energy of loop with B vector is U final, here we can write it as minus MB cos theta 2. As in final situation, the angle between M vector and B vector is theta 2. So, if we wish to find out the external work in this twist, then we can see external work done in changing orientation of loop is, this work done we can always write external work is final interaction energy minus initial interaction energy. So, if we substitute the values, this will give us MB multiplied by cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This itself is a very useful relation you should always keep in mind. There is the work done in changing the orientation of a loop in magnetic field from initial angle theta 1 to the final angle theta 2. The same can be expressed in a different form of magnetic flux also. Let's continue on the next sheet. As we have just seen that work done in changing the orientation of the loop or of the coil is MB cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. If coil carries, coil means we are talking about the same loop, carries a current I, and its area is A. This implies the work done here we can write, M can be written as IA. So, this will be IAB cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. And in this situation, we can further write it current multiplied by BA cos theta 1 minus BA cos theta 2, which can be written as I multiplied by BA cos theta 1 can be written as B dot A in the initial situation minus B dot A in the final situation. And we know that the dot product of magnetic induction with the area vector we can define as magnetic flux. It is the situation similar to what we already studied for electric flux. So, here work done can be written as I initial flux minus final flux, which can be written as minus I delta phi. Here delta phi I am writing as final flux minus initial flux, change in flux due to orientation change. Here we can write where flux we can write as B dot A, or it is written as BA cos theta is termed as magnetic flux of magnetic field induction B vector passing through the coil or loop, because we are taking area that of the loop. This is the way how magnetic flux is defined, and using magnetic flux also we can find out the total work done in changing the orientation of a coil or a loop, a current carrying coil or a loop in the magnetic induction B.